Hello world, it's Rahul.
Welcome back guys to machine learning tutorial. So we have seen in last video that how can we create clusters by making use of k-means clustering algorithm. I hope that makes sense. So guys, today we'll be going to discuss another clustering algorithm, that is hierarchical clustering. Hierarchical clustering is as simple as k-means, but instead of there being a fixed number of clusters, the number changes in every iteration. This clustering technique is divided into two, divisive and agglomerative. If the number increases, we talk about divisive clustering. All data instances start in one cluster and splits are performed in each iteration, resulting in a hierarchy of clusters. Agglomerative clustering, on the other hand, is a bottom-up approach. Each instance is a cluster at the beginning, and clusters are merged in every iteration. So guys, if you can see on the screen, data is scattered on the plane. Let's assume each data point as different clusters. Now we will try to find out two nearest points or clusters, since we are considering each point as a cluster. Let's say this is point x1 and this is point x2. And these points are having minimum distance between them. So we will create a dendogram for this as shown on the screen. Now we will try to find out which are the next nearest clusters, and these two are again creating one cluster and named as x3 and x4. Now I will create another dendogram for these points. Same I will do for point 5 and point 6. And draw a dendogram somewhere here. Now I will try to find out which is the nearest cluster among these. So if you can see, you will find out that these are pretty close. So we'll combine these clusters and create a dendogram for these points, just like shown on the screen. And at last, I will combine the whole group of clusters, as these are my next nearest cluster, and create another dendogram. Now here we will find the longest vertical line, such that none of the horizontal line is passing by. So we can conclude that we have two clusters by making use of mentioned points. This is the main objective of creating hierarchical clustering. But I know you must have one question over here, that how can we create dendogram, or how can we calculate distance among different points? So guys, let's quickly understand this by making use of one real life example. So guys, here I am using agglomerative approach. Let's say we have a matrix of 5 data points, which is representing the distance between each data points. So distance from point x1 to x1 will be 0, then distance from data point x2 to x1 will be 7, from x2 to x2 will be 0. So every diagonal value will be 0, as distance from itself will always be 0. So by same mean, matrix value is represented. Now we need to draw different clusters based on this table. So guys, first of all, we have to check which of the data point is having minimum distance with other data point in given matrix. So if you can see, data point x4 is having a minimum distance of 1 from data point x3. So we will create a cluster of data point x3 and x4. Let's draw a dendogram for the same. Again, we have to find out the minimum distance among the matrix value, but before that, we have to create a new matrix table which includes cluster of x3 and x4. So guys, let's create this matrix by keeping the values for data point x1, x2 and x5 as it is. But the thing is, how can we decide distance from cluster x3, x4 to x1, or from cluster x3, x4 to x2, or from cluster x3, x4 to x5? So guys, we will find out the distance of data point from x3 to x1 and distance from x4 to x1, and then we will check which is the minimum between two and consider that value as the distance from cluster x3 x4 to data point x1. So distance of x3 and x1 is 11 and distance of x4 and x1 is 10, and 10 is the minimum between 11 and 10. So distance from cluster x3 x4 to data point x1 will be 10. By the same way, we will find the distance from cluster x3 x4 to x2. So distance from x3 to x2 is 9 and the distance from x2 to x4 is 3. Now minimum value between 9 and 3 is 3. So distance from cluster x3 x4 to data point x2 would be considered as 3. For distance from cluster x3 x4 to x5, we will check distance from x3 to x5, that is 2, and distance from x4 to x5, that is 5, and minimum between 2 is obviously 2. So the distance from cluster x3 x4 to x5 will be 2. So our matrix table is complete. Now again we will check the least value among the table and repeat the steps. So 2 is the least distance, which is between data point x5 and cluster x3 x4. So we will draw a dendogram for cluster x3 x4 x5 at a height of 2. Let's create a new matrix table by considering cluster of x3 x4 x5. Now diagonal will be 0 as distance from its own point will be 0. Distance from x2 to x1 will be 7. But now we have to calculate distance from cluster x3 x4 x5 to data point x1 and distance from cluster x3 x4 x5 to data point x2. Let again check distance from x3 to x1, x4 to x1 and x5 to x1 and consider the minimum value among all three values. So distance from x3 to x1 is 11, distance from x4 to x1 is 10, and distance from x5 to x1 is 6, and minimum among all these is 6 only. So distance from the cluster x3 x4 x5 to data point x1 would be 6. Now we will check for data point x2. So distance from x3 to x2 is 9, distance from x4 to x2 is 3, and distance from x5 to x2 is 8, and minimum value is 3. So distance from cluster x3 x4 x5 to x2 will be 3 only. So here our new matrix formed. Now let's search for minimum value in matrix table, and that is 3. So according to our search, we will combine data point x2 with cluster x3 x4 x5 and draw a dendogram at a height of 3. So guys, now we are one step away to form final dendogram. Let's create a new matrix table by considering cluster x2, x3, x4, x5 and data point x1. So here it is on the screen. Diagonal will be 0 and now we only have to find distance for data point x1 and cluster x2, x3, x4, x5. We will calculate distance for every data point from x1 and find the minimum among all. So distance from x1 to x2 is 7, distance from x1 to x3 is 11, distance from x1 to x4 is 10 and distance from x1 to x5 is 6 and minimum value among all is 6. So distance from cluster x2, x3, x4, x5 to data point x1 will be 6 only. And we will create a dendogram at a height of 6. So this is how your dendogram will look after solving this particular problem using agglomerative clustering, where at initial we were having single data points and at last, we are having clusters of different points together. Guys, one thing to note here is, for finding the distance from cluster to data point, we were using single linkage technique. We have complete linkage technique as well, where we consider max value among all points instead of minimum value. Hope you guys like this video and understand the mathematics used behind this algorithm. Thank you guys for your time. Do like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Happy learning and stay safe.